morning, boys and girls. I hope you've been having a great week. Today's the last video because it's the last day of the week, and then hopefully we'll be back at school very soon. So we're going to first start by counting our days in December. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to put up our number 4 here. Today is December 4th, 2020. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Today is Friday. Yesterday was Thursday, Thursday, Thursday. Yesterday was Thursday. Today is Friday. And tomorrow will be Saturday. Don't forget to keep looking out your window every day and see what the weather is like. Still fall, but winter is coming very soon. And there's only 21 days left until Christmas. That's 3 more weeks. So not next Friday or the next Friday after that, but in 3 more Fridays, that will be Christmas. All right. Now, in Miss Rachel's class, we do something special on Fridays. It's called Big Book Friday. Because I have a lot of big books and I don't want to waste them, we want to use them. So I like to read our big books every Friday. So today I have one of my favorites. It's called Moon Cake. So we're going to read this big book for our Friday story time. Moon Cake. Let's see if I can hold it. Sometimes these big books are a little bit tricky to hold. Moon Cake. All right. One summer night, Bear and his friend Little Bird sat down to watch the moon. After a while, Little Bird said, "I think I feel hungry." "Me too," replied Bear. "And you know what I wish? I wish I could just jump up and take a bite out of the moon. Mmm, how delicious that would be." "How do you know?" chirped Little Bird. "Maybe the moon doesn't taste good at all. Maybe it tastes terrible." What do you think? Do you think the moon tastes good or bad? Bear thought for a moment. Then he went inside and got his bow and arrow. With a piece of string, he attached a spoon to the arrow. I wonder what he's planning to do. Then he went outside again and shot the spoon at the moon. I don't think it quite reached all the way. "I knew that wouldn't work," said Little Bird. "The moon is just too far away. What you need is a rocket ship." "Then I shall build one," said Bear. The very next day, Bear went to the junkyard and bought everything he thought he would need to build his rocket ship. All summer long, Bear and Little Bird worked and worked, but when fall came, the rocket ship was still not finished. "I would like to go with you," said Little Bird, "but winter is coming and I must fly south with the flock." So Bear and Little Bird said goodbye. When it began to get cold and the leaves fell off the trees, Bear got sleepy. But instead of climbing into bed and sleeping through the winter, he kept right on working. He worked and worked until the rocket ship was finished. Do you know why Bear was getting sleepy? He was getting sleepy because bears hibernate and sleep all winter long. Then he climbed inside and began the countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. But before he reached 1, he fell asleep. He slept and slept and slept until one night the wind knocked over his rocket ship. Bear had never been awake in the winter before. When he opened his eyes and saw all the snow, he climbed out of his rocket ship. Oops, I think I skipped one. He thought he was on the moon when he saw that snow. He had never seen it before. So he climbed out of his rocket ship, scooped up some snow, and made a little moon cake. Then he tasted it. It tasted like something he had tasted before, but he wasn't quite sure what it was. What do you think snow tastes like? What is snow made of? wonder. While he thought about that, he decided to go for a walk. He didn't want to go too far because he was afraid that he would get lost. So he just walked in a big circle. After a while, he came upon his own paw prints in the snow. He saw his little paw prints from where he had walked before. These paw prints are too big to belong to a moon mouse or even a moon raccoon, thought Bear. Maybe they were made by a moon bear, or perhaps, he shuddered, a terrible moon monster. Bear felt scared. He ran back to his rocket ship and prepared for takeoff. He didn't realize those were his own paw prints. Again, he began the countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, and again he fell asleep. And this time he slept all the way until spring. One day his friend Little Bird returned and woke him up. How was everything down south? Asked Bear. Just fine, said Little Bird. Did you go to the moon? Asked Little Bird. I sure did, said Bear. And how did the moon taste? Asked Little Bird. Was it terrible? No, replied Bear. It was delicious. The end. Was he really on the moon, or was he just on the ground in winter? He was eating snow. Remember, bears sleep all winter, so he had never seen it before, and he really thought he was on the moon. That was a fun story. Today, it's Friday, so I'm not going to give you too much work to do. I want you to try to look at some books at home because we love reading. So try to read lots of books at home with your family. And I just have one other paper you can work on today. It's called Christmas Cut and Paste. So it shows kind of what looks like a gingerbread house. There's four kind of squares on the bottom you can cut out. And if you need a little help, you can ask someone to help you. And then it's kind of like a puzzle. You have to put them in the spots where the picture matches and makes sense. So if you try one and it doesn't quite look right in that spot, then try it in a different spot. And if it doesn't look right still, you might have to turn it just like puzzle pieces. See where they match, okay? So I hope you have fun with your Christmas puzzle. You can color it when you're done. And I will see you back at school very soon. Have a great weekend. Bye.